Welcome everyone to episode 42 of Hunting Grounds. I am your host, Johnny H. And on this episode, 7 days will have their first killer go through their trials. And that killer is Albert Wesker. On last week's episode, Jackie set the bar for her team with the Skull Merchant, and I look to do the exact same thing with Wesker for 7 days. Last season, Big Al was dominant in both the Killoffs and the regular season until he got upsetted by the Wraith in the semifinals. He looks to repeat that this season and take home the Golden Hooker in the process. Here is the build that I'll be running on Big Al this week. Lightborn for the pesky Click Clicks, Flashbangers, and Firecrackers. Jolt for gen defense. Whenever I put a survivor into dying state, all generators within a 32 meter radius will instantly explode and lose 8% and start regressing. Surveillance, so I can see which generators are quiet, which generators are regressing, and which generators were regressing and are now being worked on. Merciless Storm. Whenever a survivor gets a generator to 90% complete, they will be faced with a cycle of really hard skill checks. If they miss one of these skill checks, the generator will be blocked by the entity for 20 seconds. My add-ons are Iridescent Uroboros Vial. All the survivors start the trial infected by Uroboros. If they reach maximum infection, they'll be exposed for 30 seconds. And Dark Sunglasses. Whenever a survivor is fully infected with Uroboros, I will gain undetectability for 20 seconds. My offering is Survivor Pudding. I'll gain 100% blood points in all categories, and it stacks with other blood point offerings. That's my build, and I cannot wait to start. I know Big Al's ready, so for the first time for Team 7 Days, let the hunt commence. Ha!
Disappoint me. Is that the best you've got? Performance indeed. I'll see you dead. Too bad you won't make it much further. Huh? playtime is over. Is that all you have? Seven minutes is all I can spare to play with. Just start. Is that the best you've got? Performance indeed. I'll see you dead. Playtime is over.
Ah!
You're merely postponing the inevitable. You've really become quite an inconvenience for me. Are you trying to make me angry? I shall release Uroboros. Seven minutes is all I could spare to play with you.
I'll see you dead.
Yeah.
Just accept your fate. Performance indeed.
Oh.
Just getting started. You can't hide forever! Too bad you won't make it much further. You disappoint me. Is that the best you've got? Hmph. You're merely postponing the inevitable. I shall release Uroboros. started. Seven minutes is all I can spare to play with you.
Hey!
Welcome back, everyone. And Albert Wesker absolutely dominated again for the second season in a row his trials, sacrificing every survivor except that one Claudette who got away in the third trial. And hats off to that Claudette. She played hard. She countered me. She knew how to play against Wesker. She knew how to loop. My hat's off to her. I would love to play that player again. And boy, was that third trial a battle. It could have went any way. Luckily, I was able to sacrifice three out of the four, and it went Big Al's way. Let's take a look at just how well Big Al did this week. Albert Wesker had 57 hits, 28 generator hits, downed 30 survivors, grabbed 7 survivors, hooked 34 survivors, had 0 Moris, sacrificed 15 survivors, let 1 survivor escape, and is the second killer to have an undefeated record, but the first to have a true undefeated record with 4 wins, 0 losses, and 0 ties. So we've seen 2 killers so far this season. The Skull Merchant went 3-0-1, and now Albert Wesker 4-0-0. Both killers going undefeated. What a way to start Hunting Grounds. I sent out Wesker first, like I said, because I wanted to do what Jackie did and set the bar for my team, and it looks like he did just that. Here's a look at the updated Golden Hooker standings. On the left side of the bracket, for 7 days, Albert Wesker debuts in first place with 342 points. On the right side of the brackets, for the Bloody Court, the Skull Merchant is in first place with 306 points. 342 points is a great debut, not only for Albert Wesker, but for 7 days. He's down a bit though from last season. Last season, Wesker debuted with 366 points and he finished the season in second place. 342 points would be enough to get him second place last season. We'll see what happens this season and if anyone's gonna be able to top that. Now it's time to hear from Jackie to find out which killer will be completing their trials on next week's episode of Hunting Grounds.
All right, everybody. I hope you enjoyed episode 42 of the Hunting Grounds. Next up, representing the Bloody Court, will be the artist. Last season, Cinderella, who placed fourth overall. Will she finally have her chance at revenge? Will she get to face last season's champion and prove who is the better killer? Stay tuned for next week's episode of Hunting Grounds. As always, if you like the show, please like and subscribe to show your love. Be safe, and we'll see you in the fog.